welcome to my channel. I'm Bella Stone, and if you're new here, thanks so much for stopping by. If you are a returning viewer, thank you so much for the continued support. I really appreciate it. And here's a special hello from the kittens.
Hey guys, do you have anything you want to say?
Oh, wow, you actually said something this time.
What about you, Sully? Remember those thrilling hours immersed in Game Boy classics, like Pokemon, Kirby's Dream Land, and Zelda, A Link to the Past? Imagine resurrecting those childhood favorites with pixel-perfect modern innovation, colors that pop, and nostalgia that's gonna transport you back in time. Now the Analog Pocket is that time machine. In today's video, we're gonna dive into the world of retro gaming with the Analog Pocket. We're gonna see exactly what makes it so special, how it compares to the original Game Boy and the Nintendo Switch, and of course, my overall thoughts on the console. Now, it's not just about gaming either. It has a built-in digital audio workstation. So we're gonna explore how gaming and music production can go hand in hand in just a bit. Who knows, we might even build a game together. Now, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell if you wanna see more topics like this, but let's get started. Imagine having an HD TV in your pocket. With the resolution of 1600 by 1440, it's an impressive 10 times sharper than the original Game Boy. But here's the kicker. It maintains that classic DMG or dot matrix graphic display style with a touch of modern backlight LCD magic. And if you're all about those razor sharp visuals, it packs 615 pixels per inch, while the original only had 85. When you stack it up against the most recent handhelds, the Analog Pocket pixel density is notably superior. To put things in perspective, the Nintendo Switch clocks in at 237 ppi, and the Steam Deck follows close behind with 215 ppi. The Analog Pocket takes the lead with its significantly higher pixel density. It's got a nifty 360-degree display rotation feature, perfect for some tape mode gaming excitement. You can even put your own artistic stamp on it with customizable box art, making your game collection truly your own. And we haven't even touched on its toughness. This device's display is made from Gorilla Glass, a solid 3 times thicker than your typical smartphone glass, measuring 1.5 millimeters. It's not just sharp, it's sturdy too. As for the sound, this device comes equipped with stereo speakers, delivering an audio experience that complements those stunning visuals. It's compatible with a DAC, or digital to analog converter, to take your audio quality up a notch. And for those moments when you're eager to share your gaming adventure on a grand scale, this device offers a convenient 1080p HDMI output. Simply plug it into the analog dock, and you're all set for a TV gaming experience with up to 3 friends. Now, let's check out what's inside this. We're diving into the hardware features of the Analog Pocket, measuring just 3.46 by 5.86 by 0.86 inches. It's smaller than the original Game Boy, but packs a punch in terms of technology. Instead of using regular software, the Analog Pocket uses something called FPGAs, field programmable gate arrays. What's special about these? They make your gaming experience super accurate and speedy, giving you that classic gaming feel without any lags or issues you might find in other consoles. If you want to know more about the difference between FPGAs and the real thing, I'll link some resources down below that dives deeper into this. It's powered by a rechargeable lithium-ion 4300 mAh battery. It delivers 6 to 10 hours of gameplay. That's perfect for those long gaming sessions without worrying about running out of battery. And when it's time to recharge, it's quick and easy with the USB-C charging. Regular charge time is around 4 to 5 hours. It's only 2 hours though if you're using the analog fast charging power supply. Don't forget to complete your firmware updates on the Analog Pocket support page to make sure you have the latest versions. First, download the new firmware. Plug in your micro SD card formatted to either FAT32 or XFAT. Make sure you don't have other firmware files on that card. Place the firmware file on the root of your micro SD card. Power your pocket off fully, then insert the micro SD card into the pocket. Power your pocket on, and the pocket will automatically begin to update. The pocket will display a progress update bar as we see here on the screen. The update process takes between 3 to 4 minutes. Do not power off the pocket during this process or disturb the unit in any way. When the pocket is finished updating, it will auto reboot. let's take a look at some of our games. You can use the Pocket to play games from consoles like Game Gear, Neo Geo Pocket Color, Atari Lynx, and more, all on this single device. There are three ways to enjoy gaming in this system. You can use the game cartridges directly, utilize the adapters, or you can plug in your microSD card to expand your gaming collection even more. Right off the bat, Analog offers a free game called Space War. We can download its zip file right from GitHub. Then drop it in your microSD card. Make sure you unzip the file. Then move the corresponding folders into your microSD core folders. Why this game? Well, it's a tribute to the very first digital video game that hit the scene back in early 1962. It ran on a computer known as the PDP-1, way back in 1959 at MIT. You can use many of the accessories with these games, including the Game Boy camera, pocket printer, and many others. Let's talk about the controllers that are compatible too. Here's the full list of supported controllers. You can play with your PS3, 4, and 5 controllers, all the way to some of your more legacy picks. The analog dock has two USB inputs for wired controllers, but you can add more with wireless options. Now that we have a better sense of the Analog Pocket, why not make our own game? Analog partnered with GB Studio so we can bring our own game ideas to life. The creator of GB Studio is Chris Malpe, a London-based developer. Now I'm gonna make my first project. Let's click on the play button on the top right to see the sample project in action. This reminds me so much of one of my favorite games, which was Courage the Cowardly Dog CreepDB. How can I tweak this? I'm a huge fan of the show Hilda, and I believe its vibrant colors and cute drawings would make for an adorable minigame. I'm gonna start off by changing the logo that comes right before the title screen. It was not a fan of my image's dimensions not being a multiple of 8. Keep this in mind when working on your projects. I'm gonna mess around with the studio for a bit and get familiar with how it works. See you in a few with everything I came up with while using the software. I didn't make too many changes besides messing with the color palette and adding my own background and tweaking the sign, but there's a lot you can explore with the GB Studio. I also replaced the elephant with the sprite cat to resemble Twig from the show. When you're crafting your games, you might wonder how to switch up the music. Well, the cool thing is you can use your Pocket's digital audio workstation to create awesome beats right there. Let's check out NanoLoop. This versatile software, also known as DAW or Digital Audio Workstation, is like your all-in-one music studio in a box. Connect it to your computer or other gear using MIDI and sync cables, and dive into creating tunes. It's got a built-in synthesizer generating those electronic sounds, and a sequencer that's like your composer, letting you program note sequences, rhythms, and effects automatically. NanoLoop operates in a 16-step loop or a 4x4 matrix, giving you the power to tweak each step. Play with pitch, experiment with LFO or low-frequency oscillation, shape enveloping sounds, and explore different waveforms to sculpt your sound just how you want it. Why just talk about it when we can make our own songs? Let's play around with it together. When we start it up, we're gonna have a few options here in the sequence parameter. So if we look down here, the first option that we have is with the volume. We can put different steps here just so you have a sense of how it would work. I'm gonna take out some of them so it's not too overwhelming for us to see how we can really change it up. So the options that we have here is if we hold B on the step, and then we move up or down, we're gonna be changing its volume. And then if we move it left to right while still holding B, we change the length of the beat. And if we go back, we then can mess around with the pitch. And our options for the pitch is if we hold B and move up or down, we're gonna be changing the semitone. If we move it left or right, we're manipulating the octave. Next, we have the LFO. If we put a couple beats just to feel it out here, and
I'm just gonna leave one so we can mess around with it. So if we hold B and move it up or down, we're gonna change its amplitude. This is definitely the most fun so far. Like, makes it sound very wonky. And then if we move it left or right, we're changing the frequency. Let's go back to see what other options we have. We have the waveform. And we can change it up by holding B, moving it up or down. And this is gonna be the cutoff, or the modulation. And then moving it left or right is gonna be the pulse width. And then all the way to the right, we have the panning or the delay. So if we were to put a couple here, moving it up or down is gonna cause it to have a higher delay. And then moving it left and right is gonna be panning. There's also some other settings that you can see here.
These are some of the beats that I came up with while playing around.
I hope you enjoyed learning more on the Analog Pocket and how it compares to the retro classics. I had a really great time building that game together, and I'm really curious to see how I'm gonna explore the digital audio workstation more. If you did enjoy the video, don't forget to like down below. And if you want to keep up with all of my tech shenanigans, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell. Now, a couple of questions that I have for you all is, which games are you most excited to see on the revamped screen? And what are your favorite handhelds? Mine would have to be my modded Game Boy Advance, but the Analog Pocket, which is glow in the dark, also looks sick. And that is definitely a close second. But let me know your thoughts on the comments down below or across my socials on Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch. Your support means the world to me. But until next time, my friends, keep exploring, keep learning, and keep spreading those good vibes. See you next time. Bye. Relax. Chill out. I need to catch up. Okay. Oh. So bright.